So you have your weld casing coming out of the ground, and you need to know what to do to bring your pipe and your wire out. There's two main options here. One is a weld cap, and the other is a weld seal. If you're in a colder climate, you're going to have a weld cap and most likely a pitless adapter down below the ground. Today we're not going to talk about that, but we are going to talk about weld seals. So off to my left here, I have a couple of different weld seals. They're various sizes. Here we have a metal weld seal, and here's a plastic weld seal. It doesn't make a big difference which one you end up using. They'll both work just fine. So the first step in sizing it is making sure you know the inside diameter of your weld casing. So up here we're going to look, and this one's right about 4.5 inches. And if you have a non-standard size weld casing, you're going to have to find the closest available weld seal. Other common standard sizes are 5-inch, 6-inch. There's a couple of 7 inches out there, but then most of them jump up to the 8 or 10 inch size. So if we look at our weld seal, it's made up of a couple of different parts. On the top, we have our top plate. This forms the lip, which sits on the edge of the weld casing. There's usually a rubber seal inside, and then our bottom plate, which is threaded, which has the through bolts going from the top plate to the bottom plate. That way, when you set it down in your weld casing, if you so choose, you can tighten this up, put a little pressure on there to help seal and lock out any moisture or any water from entering your weld casing. So the main point of a weld seal is to prevent contaminants from coming down into your well and to hold your drop pipe in order to hold all the load from the drop pipe, the wire, and your well pump. So let's walk through some of the main components here and how we're going to set up our well seal. So in front of me, we have a mock-up of our well casing with well seal. So let's pull this up and take a look at the individual components. So in this case, we would be using a poly pipe as our drop pipe. That would connect to a barb, which connects to a coupler, which then connects to, in this case, a 1-inch through nipple. The through hole in a lot of your well seals are going to be either 3/4, 1-inch, 1.25, or then larger for your higher volume. But for most residential, a 1-inch would be a very common size. So we have our through nipple, in this case it's 4 inches long. And then at the top we have a T here. And there's two different ways to connect the T, either horizontal or vertical. Either one doesn't matter. It's mostly preference on which way you desire to go. So this whole assembly sits down on top of our weld casing, and the lip here pushes against the weld casing, and this takes the entire load from your pipe, your well pump, your wire, everything else, and reacts it against this top plate. So the lip of this T is pushing against the top plate, which pushes against your top of the well, and that holds everything in place. So once it's in this position, you can do the rest of your plumbing. So a lot of the times you'll bring your outlet here off to your water source, or your outlet here off to your water supply. So you'll notice a couple of extra holes on the top of your well seal. There's one here, this is for your wire, and if you want to bring your safety rope up through this hole and tie it off, you can do that, or else you can tie it off inside to your metal fittings. The other hole is for a vent. It's not always needed. If you find you have a really tight fitting and that your wire makes a tight fit through the wire opening, you may need to open up this hole and allow it to vent. So as you're pumping water out, you're not drawing a vacuum within your well casing. Then we have our outlet side. So in this case, we're using the T. You can also use a right angle fitting if you like, if you don't want the extra opening. But in this case, we have a T. From this side will be our outlet. We'll bring this over to wherever we're pumping the water. And up here, we can either just cap it off and have this for a lifting handle later, or for opening it up and cleaning anything out. Or else a lot of the times, you can either put pressure gauge up here if you want to see the pressure at your wellhead, or much more common, you'll put a safety relief pressure valve. That way, if any of your down plumbing either freezes, kinks, or gets plugged up, it won't overpressurize your lines. If your pump keeps running with your line frozen, then the pressure relief valve will relieve the pressure and prevent any of your lines from breaking or bursting under the high pressure. So that's the basics of a weld seal. In this case, we like to use stainless steel hardware. You can also use plastic. You can also use galvanized if you want to save a little bit of cost. But if you go for it one time, buy the stainless, it's gonna last a lifetime and you won't have to worry about it rusting or corroding. So this is Mike with RPS Solar Pumps, and that's the basics of well seals. Check out our other videos. We have videos on wiring your pump and also plumbing your pump. Also, we'll come back later and we'll do a quick video on well caps and pitless adapters and how to use them and install it. If you want a solar pump, come to rpssolarpumps.com. Check it out. We can help you out with a system today.